I am emotionally ruined. Hello everybody, it's Katie here. This week we had our 20th episode, and originally it was supposed to be our season 3 finale. Oh, do you remember back in the good old days when we first found out that we were getting a full season for season 3? We were getting a whole 20 episodes. We celebrated so much. We were so happy because we were getting more Shadowhunters. Little did we know it'd be our last. So given the fact that this was supposed to be the last episode of the season, there was a lot going on. I have to say that this is probably one of my top Shadowhunters episodes. It seemed to go by really quickly, and I will say that the ending was very sudden, but everything was done so beautifully. I don't even know where to start with episode 20. Let's start with the overall plot of this episode, and then I'll deal with the other things that went on afterwards. I don't know, I'm a mess. There's a lot to think about. So Clary is still evil and gallivanting around with Jonathan. They have kidnapped the Sealy Queen, so the episode opens on her being imprisoned. I did like the scene between the Sealy Queen and Jonathan at the start. I am reading Queen of Air and Darkness at the moment. There are things in that that are the consequence of the stuff that happened in Lost Souls and Heavenly Fire with Jonathan and the Sealy Queen. So being in the middle of that book and then having to watch scenes between them in the show, it was very strange because oh boy, do they cause a lot of shit in the Shadow World. Yeah. So we only got a brief scene between the two of them, but I did enjoy it. And then Clary appeared with her whole creepy I am a true Morgenstern routine. What I did love though was even as Clary was under this influence of Jonathan's because of the rune, in that extremely creepy moment where he tried to kiss her, she still made sure he stayed in his place and reminded him that he is her brother. Some parts of Clary, the actual Clary, was still in there and fighting to be heard. I'm so relieved that we skipped over that whole scene that happens in Lost Souls where he attacks Clary, because that is my least favourite scene in all of Cassandra Clare's books. I hate it! So it was an attempt at a kiss, but Clary pushed it away, so yay. No more creepy sibling incest. Woohoo! Melion is pissed off about the Queen being kidnapped. He agrees to sneakily allow the Shadowhunters to enter the Sealy Court to try and stop Clary and Jonathan. And so we have Jace, Alec and Izzy sneaking into Faerie. At first they tell Luke and Simon not to get involved because Glorious is there, and Glorious could shatter and will definitely kill Downworlders. So, you know, they were right to tell Luke and Simon to stay away, but you know, Simon is Simon. He was going to sneak in, obviously. Then we had this showdown between Clary and Jonathan and the rest of them. Good lord, I was not ready for that fight between Clary and Izzy. No! That was so hard to watch because I love their friendship, and you could just see the conflict in Izzy's face. She didn't want to fight Clary, but she had no choice. Yeah, that was horrible. It was a beautifully crafted scene, and the swords glowing made a perfect touch, but it was sad. Yeah. And then Simon shows up and does his best to convince Clary that this isn't her. The one thing I will say about this season is we did not get enough Clary and Simon, in my opinion. I just wanted some quality scenes between the two of them because I like seeing them talk things over, and we didn't really get that this season. But I suppose that is because Clary was the one that ended up being twinned to her demonic brother instead of Jace, so I can understand why she's been a little busy this season. So this whole fight happens and Jace plummets the sword through Clary's rune, and it works, but you know, it pisses off Sebastian. Jonathan, I've gone back to calling him Sebastian just because I'm mid Queen of Air and Darkness. So Jonathan ends up sprouting his wings, so he's no longer under arrest because he flies off and he's very mad and he's got the sword. Glorious does shatter, but Izzy protects Simon. She jumps over him to stop the shards from hitting him, and they hit her instead. And Susie. The good thing is that Clary managed to get Jonathan to trust her enough to teach her how to move the apartment, so she is able to move it to Alicante, which we got to see more of in this episode before it was completely destroyed. That scene where the apartment landed and you could see the demon towers and the rest of the city, and oh, it just looked so stunning, and I'm mad that we didn't get more of a chance to explore it. Before we get into this battle that happens at the end, I need to talk about Malik. So Mayrus is our hero in this episode. Magnus has been spending time with Asmodeus. He's been manipulating Magnus, trying to get him to come back to Eden with him so that they can be powerful. The one good thing that Asmodeus did in this episode was turn Lorenzo into a chameleon. That was a good scene, just because I absolutely hate Lorenzo, so you know, it was nice to see him get some comeuppance. But other than that, Asmodeus can choke. Mayrus talks to Alec in the Institute about the fact that she hasn't heard anything else from him since he took the family ring. Alec explains part of what happened. Mayrus starts piecing things together and goes to see Magnus. When she gave Magnus the ring, and it hit home for Magnus that Alec was gonna propose, and it all came together and he realised what was going on. Oh, honestly, I love Mayrus in this show. She's such a badass. Magnus ends up sending his father into limbo, which I did love, but it also leaves me questioning where this finale is going to go. Unless Asmodeus gets out of limbo somehow and we still have those scenes in Eden with him. I don't know. So we go back to this battle in Alicante. The demon towers have broken. Jonathan has managed to get in, bring demons in through a portal using the sword. It's absolute mayhem. There are demons everywhere. The city's under attack. I noticed that the episode was called City of Glass, and to me this battle at the end really reminded me of the end of City of Glass. So I like the way they kind of merged the stories a little bit. It's just sad that the first time we properly get to explore Alicante is when it's being attacked by Jonathan. They're all trying to fight the demons. You have Alec and Izzy are trying to shoot them, and then Magnus turns up. I got so many flashbacks to City of Glass in that moment, honestly. And then you had Jason Clary. Clary was trying to talk sense into her brother, which was never gonna happen, but you know, she's Clary, so she was gonna try anyway. He realizes that no matter what, she's not really going to side with him, so he destroys the sword. There's no way to stop these demons from coming in. Everyone realizes they're doomed, and then we get to the absolute crushing ending. So Magnus remembers what his father told him about how he can be more powerful in Eden, so he volunteers to go there to use his stronger magic to close the rift and stop the demons from coming in. That's the only way they're going to be able to stop this. But before he goes, he takes out the Lightwood family ring that Mayrus had given to him earlier. And even though Alec's been planning to propose to Magnus this whole time, it's Magnus that proposes to him. Oh my god, when I tell you, I cried. I watched Shadowhunters with my mum and my sister because all three of us have read and loved the books for years. So the show is something that we always watch together. All three of us were crying when Alec started crying. It was the worst. I cannot praise Matthew Daddario enough for this scene. He deserves the world, honestly. He deserves every acting award that's ever been invented, because this scene literally tore me apart. The sheer emotion that went into that, Magnus was promising to come back. When we had Alec trying to reassure himself that it's Eden and Magnus will come back because he always comes back, and then he kneels on the floor and the rest of them gather around him. No. I was not ready for that. That was awful. Yeah, it was horrific. With Magnus going off to Eden, I assume the plan, if they'd have gotten another season, was to follow City of Heavenly Fire's storyline. I have a feeling that season 4 would have been the other characters going to Eden to try and rescue Magnus. So I'm angry that the writers never got the chance to fully expand on the story and to do City of Heavenly Fire justice, because now they have to squeeze what was going to be a whole season into 2 hours. What I love about this season is the way they've managed to still have the book's storyline, but to change it up in a way to fit a show, because it's so difficult to make a show out of a book. There's just so many things that you do have to change, you don't have a choice in that. But I really feel like they stayed loyal to the Lost Souls plot, because Lost Souls is one of my favourite books out of all the Mortal Instruments stories. So to see it unfold throughout a season has been amazing. I'm just so stressed about next week, honestly. I do want to mention the other things that happened in this episode. Maya and Jordan. Oh boy. I wasn't ready to be that emotional over this, because, you know, I've said in the past that I'm not a fan of the Maya and Jordan relationship. I didn't like them getting back together in the books, so I knew I wasn't going to like it in the show. I will say that this, how it was done in the show, was personally, to me, more heartbreaking than the way it happened in the books. In the books, I wasn't the biggest fan of Jordan, so I didn't really feel that much emotion when he died, as harsh as that sounds. Whereas in the show, I did feel sorry for him towards the end, as much as I didn't want to. The fact that he wasn't actually cured from his silver poisoning and he knew he was going to die? I wasn't expecting that at all. In my last video, I was talking about how I thought Jordan was going to try and slip Maya the serum to turn her into a human again. But no, he stole it because he wanted her to have a fresh start, to have a new chance at life, because he wasn't going to be there. And, you know, it makes a lot more sense now as to why he would make that decision. It was horrible. When Maya came out at the end and saw him sitting there, yeah, wasn't ready for that. So whilst Maya's heart was breaking over Jordan's death, we had Luke getting called in by the Praetor and told to steal the serum for them. I hated this scene between Luke and Maya on the bridge, because at this point I knew what Luke was doing. I knew that it was the serum that the Praetor wanted, and you had Maya talking about how no one should have that amount of power, and he had to lie to her, and that must have torn him apart inside, because he respects Maya so much. I know I said this last week, but I do feel like the show was setting up a bigger storyline for Luke with the Praetor, but obviously that's not going to happen. But with that not happening now, I am curious to see how they wrap that up in the special. Genuinely, I don't know what to expect from next week, other than a Malak wedding. But other than that, I don't know what they're going to do. I don't know whether they're going to try and stick to City of Heavenly Fire, or whether, faced with having to wrap this up in 2 hours, the writers just decided to do their own thing and come up with their own ending. I wouldn't blame them. So I don't know, really. Oh my god, what I did forget to mention was that Helen and Aileen were in this episode. I love them so much. And we've only seen 2 scenes of them together. I'll tell you what I am pissed off about. If we'd have gotten another season, we could have had the rest of Helen's family introduced. You know, we could have had the Blackthorns. A huge part of Heavenly Fire is Mark Blackthorn being taken. And, you know, if we'd have had a 4th season, enough time to fully explore City of Heavenly Fire, we could have done that. We could have had Mark. But no, that's not gonna happen now. Poor Helen and Aileen have been done so dirty. So even though their appearance in the show as a whole is brief, I'm so glad that they were included. I just hope we get to see more of them in the finale. I don't know what I actually want from the finale at this point. When I was thinking about it as a show and as a season, I wanted a lot more content for Jem. I wanted his story explored more. I wanted them to eventually bring in Tessa. You know, all of the stuff that happened in City of Heavenly Fire. I wanted the show to eventually expand on that, but obviously it's just a 2-hour finale now, so I understand they're not going to be able to introduce all these characters that I wanted to see. I would at least like Jem to be turned back into Jem. That is the one thing from the book that I hope they still include in the finale. I don't know whether they have time to do that, but I would like him to go back to being Jem instead of Brother Zachariah. I would like his story explained a little bit, because Jem is one of my favourite characters in the whole Shadow World, which is why I was so eager for him to appear in the first place. So I just hope that in this finale there is time to delve into his story a little bit. As for the rest of it, I honestly don't know. Whatever happens, I am sure that I'll be happy with it. We know how much the writers and the whole crew adore this show, so I'm sure whatever they've done, they will have done it justice. So that's about all that I can think of to say in regards to this episode. As always, there is probably lots that I've forgotten to mention, so if there is anything you would like to discuss, feel free to leave it down in the comments. Please do talk to me about all the Shadowhunters things, because we only have a week left after next week. That's it, we don't get any more, and I'm sad. So yeah, please do let me know all of your thoughts. Tell me your predictions for next week. What do you think is going to happen? I'm terrible at coming up with theories, so I have no idea. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you next week. Bye!